In this video, we will try to understand how we can apply Windows authentication to MVC applications. So you can see that, you know, I have selected ASP.NET MVC 3 web application here, and I've given a nice name here saying MVC Windows authentication sample, and I'm going to go and press OK. And what we'll do is, you know, we'll go and select this empty template here, and we're going to use the Razor view engine to go and create our views. Now, in case you are new to Razor, you know, what my suggestion would be, please do go and see the previous video where we have explained what exactly is Razor, and we have also what you call introduced the Razor syntaxes and how to use them in project. So let me just go and select this empty template here, and let me select the Razor as the view engine, and let me press OK. And you can see that it has created the default solution explorer here with the necessary folders, that is controller, models and views. So what we'll do is, let's go ahead and create a very simple controller here, and we'll name this controller as view page, let's say. And in this controller, you know, we'll create two actions. You know, one action is only for admins, and the other action is for a simple user. So I'll go and create one simple action here saying for admin, okay, and I'll go and create one more action here which is for simple users, right? And let's just make this A capital, you know, just to have proper naming convention. So what we'll do now here is, we'll try to achieve the following. The first thing, anybody who is a registered user in the local user group or in the Windows ADS, you know, can call this MVC application. So in other words, you know, the user should be, you know, belonging to this local user groups. He should be a registered user in this local user group, or else he won't be able to go and access this application. Right, that's the first point. Now the second point is, you can see in the view page controller, I have two actions here, for admin and for simple users. Now this for simple users can be called by any user from the user group. In other words, accountant, administrator, guest, shiv, anyone can go and call this for simple users. But the for admin can only be invoked by administrator. So let's try to achieve this demo. This application can only be accessed by people who are, you know, who are registered user in the Windows group. First thing, the for admin can be accessed by only administrator, and the for simple user can be accessed by anyone who is a registered user in the local user group. So the first thing what we need to do is, we need to go to the web config file, and we need to go and change, you know, the authentication to Windows. So in other words, the first thing, we have to go and change this to Windows, right? And so that is step one. Second, in the authorization, we need to ensure that we do not allow users who are anonymous. So deny users, you know, whose identity we do not know. So the first step is, we need to go and change the authentication mode to Windows. And the second step is, we need to ensure that the authorization denies any kind of users, you know, who are anonymous. The second thing what we need to do is, we need to go and add some keys into this app setting. You can see that I have added two keys here. One is auto forms authentication equal to false, and enable simple membership equal to false. Okay. Now these two keys, you know, I have added because there is one what you call defect in MVC 3 template. So I have gone ahead and I have added these keys here. So in case you are using MVC 4 or some template, you know, where this defect is fixed, then probably you do not need to do this step, you know. But for now, at least, you know, for my PC, you know, I had to do this step, right? You know, what exactly this step is, you know, basically we are saying that we are going to use Windows authentication. So please ensure that the forms authentication and the membership authentications are disabled. Okay. And the third step, what we need to do is, we need to go and use the authorize attribute to specify that, you know, who are the users who can go and access this controller. So we need to say here, authorize its attribute users. The first user whom we want to give access, you know, to this controller is the administrator, and the second user is we'll give it to shiv. There is one more user called a shiv over there. Okay, right. So these two users, you know, can go and access, you know, this controller. But then, you know, in the controller later, the for admin action can only be accessed by administrators. So this can only be accessed by administrators. Okay. Right. But the for simple users, you know, can be accessed by administrators as well as by shape. Right. So you can see like how I've defined specific user access on each action. Great. So let me just go and build this so that, you know, we do not have any errors, just to ensure. So all succeeded. Good. And also let's go ahead and create two views, one view for the admin and one view for the simple user, so that, you know, we can understand that, you know, who is running what. So let's right click here and say, okay, let's add a view here. You know, this view is only for admin. So I'm going to keep the same name for admin, and currently we'll not use any master page layout as such. Right. So this is one view. And here I will say this can be only accessed by admin, right? And let's go ahead and create one more view, you know, for simple users. So let me right click, add a view for simple users, add view, and I'll say this is for simple users, right? So you can see now we have two views, one is for admin and one is for simple users. Great. Now the next thing is, you know, we would like to go and test this application. So we have given all the necessary things what we need to give in the web config file. We have created two pages, we have created two controllers, we already have the users in our local user group. So now it is time to go and test this application. Now, in order the Windows authentication to work, right, you know, this application has to be deployed into Internet Information Server or in the IIS. Means you cannot test Windows authentication by using your simple Visual Studio. The Cassini web server, you know, in which your application runs, when you run from Visual Studio, does not support Windows authentication as such. Okay. So we need to go and deploy this application in IIS. And then from there, you know, we can test, you know, if this code is working or not. Okay. So first thing is, let me just go and build everything here just to ensure that all things are fine. So rebuild solution, that is good. And the next thing is, let me just go and open my IIS here. So start run inet mgr. And now before we go and deploy this application on IIS, you know, we need to go and publish the compiled DLS into some folder, right? So let's go ahead to our G drive here. And let's create a very simple folder here saying new folder my test Windows MVC, right? And let's deploy the MVC application inside this folder over here. So let me just copy this path from here. Let's go here, let's go to build, and let's go to publish. Now before we go and publish this application into that folder, you know, we need to ensure that all the necessary MVC DLLs, the framework DLLs, are also included, you know, in this publish, or else, you know, your MVC application will not work with IIS. So in order to ensure that, you know, all the necessary dependencies of the MVC libraries are present in your application, what you can do is that right click on your MVC application, and you can see here over here we have one very nice menu here called as add deployable dependencies. So if you click on this link, right, what it will do is it will actually go and ensure that all the necessary MVC dependency, you know, MVC DLLs, the framework DLLs, are also shipped with this project so that your application can work in a proper manner in the IIS. So I'm going to go and say, okay, go and add all the necessary dependencies. Now he's also, you know, going and fine tuning your dependency, saying that, have you used ASP.NET MVC or you want to also include Razor dependency? So for now, I'll just take Razor because I've used my view engine as Razor, and I'll just say, okay. All right. So you can see once I do okay, it has created a folder here called as bin deployable assemblies, and you can see all the necessary DLLs which are necessary to run your application has been included in this whole solution, right? So now let's go ahead and say build publish. So now that we have all the DLLs here, and we'll go and publish onto that file system. Let me just go and select this delete all existing files prior to publish, so that you know any kind of old files, you know, they get deleted and this new ones actually go and get published into the directory. And let me hit on publish. Now the time I hit on publish, you can see that inside this folder here, my test Windows MVC, it has actually gone ahead and put all the necessary compiled DLLs, you know, which are needed to run this MVC application. Now the next thing is we need to go to our IIS and let's go ahead and create a very simple website, you know, which will help us to run this MVC application. So let me go to my IIS here. So let me click on the sites here and I'll say add website, my MVC test. And in the physical path, you know, we'll give that folder, you know, where our MVC application has been published. Okay. Now already in this PC, you know, there are applications which are running on 80 ports. So I need to use some other port here. So I'll use must be 3131 just to be safe. And let me press OK. Now once I press OK, you can see that, you know, on the left hand side, this my MVC test site has been created. But you can see that it has a red cross sign here saying that, you know, this site has been created, you know, but it cannot be started. In other words, it's not running. So why is this site not running? You can see all the other sites are running, you know, but this new freshly created site is not running. It is not running because you have created your MVC application using the .NET 4.0 framework. And currently this my MVC test has been deployed in the 2.0 framework. So in other words, if you see this my MVC test and if you go to application pool here, you can see over here we have this my MVC test here. If you double click on it, you can see that the .NET framework version which it is using currently is .NET 2.0. So what I'll do is I'm going to go and select this 4.0 here and I'm going to say OK. And I will go here and do a refresh. And now you can see that the red sign has gone. In other words, now my application, my MVC test, you know, is up and running, you know, on my PC. Right. Now the next thing is, you know, let's try to go and browse this website. So I'm going to go and click on browse here. You can see that our application has ran, but it is showing me access denied here. Why? Because we have missed one more step here, that is specifying the authentication. So go and select this My MVC Test web application. Go to this authentication menu here and enable Windows authentication. And all the other guys go and disable them. So you can see that I've gone to this My MVC Test and I've just enabled Windows authentication here. So let me go and now again do a refresh here. You can now see that the box has popped up. So what I'll do is I'm going to go and specify your administrator, the password, right. Now, if I try to go and run this for admin or for simple users, you know, I should be able to go and access the pages. So in other words, if I go here and say slash for admin, we need to also specify the controller name, that is view page. So view page. So if you see now, I can see the web page, you know, which can be accessed by only admin. Also, if I go and try to access for simple users, I should be able to access it. Why? Because currently I'm logged in as admin. Okay. Now let me do like this. Let me go and close this. And again, let me go and browse. I'm going to go to my MVC test here. And in this my MVC test, let me just go and browse my application here. And what I'll do is I'll try to go and browse the admin action straightforward. So you can see that I am trying to go and browse the admin action. Now, if I try to give here what you call shiv, right? You can see it does not work, right? Why? Because this view page for admin is only accessible, you know, for administrator. So if I give your administrator, this will work, right? Now what I'll do is, now let me go and log in as shiv, right? And let me go and try to browse simple users. So you can see that, you know, now I'm logged in as shiv, I can browse to simple users, but I cannot browse to admin. You can see here again popped up me a box saying that you are shiv and in order to go and access this page, you have to be admin. Right, so I hope that you know you have understood how to do Windows authentication for MVC application. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand how we can apply Windows authentication for MVC applications. Thank you very much.